If I picked up this broken glass with my bare hands, I would be putting myself in danger of an exposure to bloodborne pathogens. It appears whoever broke this glass cut themselves. Now, suppose they have an infectious disease such as HIV or HBV. This is a proper way to pick up broken glass. By using a broom and dustpan, the glass never comes into contact with my skin. This is an example of proper work practice. Proper work practices and engineering controls are the primary methods used to prevent exposure to pathogens from blood and other potential infectious materials. Proper work practices reduce risk by changing the way a task is performed to minimize the hazard. In the hospitality industry, housekeepers are trained to fold sheets back one at a time to reduce the risk of injury from items left in the bedding. That's another proper work practice. Engineering controls reduce employee exposure by either removing or isolating the hazard or isolating the worker from exposure. Engineering controls for bloodborne pathogens are more prevalent in the healthcare industry because most of them have to do with the use of sharp devices such as needles and scalpels. In non-healthcare industries, the emphasis for protection is on proper work practices and personal protective equipment. If your company has a sharps disposal container, then you have an engineering control. Personal protective equipment will be covered in the next section. In this section on engineering controls and work practices, we'll go into more detail about engineering controls and proper work practices and give examples of each. We'll also review the bloodborne pathogen standard where it applies to controls and practices. Remember, it's to your benefit to read the standard. You can find a link to the rules on the resource page.